वेलकम फ्रेंड्स, लेट अस कंटिन्यू टू स्टडी स्टीम जनरेटर ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट डिफरेंट माउंटिंग्स सच एज फीड चेक वाल्व, फ्यूजिबल प्लग एंड ब्लो ऑफ कॉक। फीड चेक वाल्व, दिस इज द स्केच फॉर द फीड चेक वाल्व एंड इट हैज ए नॉन रिटर्न वाल्व। नॉन रिटर्न वाल्व मीन्स इट इज ए वन वे वाल्व। Location: feed check valve is located on a boiler drum at a level below the normal water level inside the boiler drum. Functions of the feed check valve are: it controls the direction of water flowing through it. It means it allows the flow of water only in one direction. It allows the water flow in one direction only. It means from outside of the boiler to inside of the boiler only. It also controls the quantity of water flowing through it. It means the how much amount of water should be passed. That is again also controlled with the help of the feed check valve. Working: as we know that water is continuously heated into boiler and converted into steam, and so water level in the boiler reduces. So it becomes necessary to supply the water to the boiler, and the water which is supplied to the boiler, that is known as the feed water, and so the name is the feed check valve. Means whatever the water is entering into the boiler, it is to be checked. It is to be checked for the pressure as well as quantity, and so it is known as the feed check valve. As the boiler is working at high pressure, it is essential that pressure of feed water must be higher than the boiler pressure. If it is not, then what will happen? Water will not enter into the boiler, but that can be a reverse flow. Water from the boiler can come out, and so the pressure of feed water is increased with the help of the feed pump. So initially water is entered into the feed pump, where the pressure of the water is increased, and high pressure water is entered into the feed check valve. So the high pressure water is passed through the feed check valve. Non-return valve is acted upon by two pressures, that is the upward pressure and downward pressure. So you can see here, whenever high pressure water enters into the feed check valve, it is their non-return valve. The first part in between is the non-return valve, and the non-return valve is acted upon by two pressures. One is upward pressure, another one is the downward pressure. Upward direction pressure is due to the high pressure feed water, and downward direction pressure is due to the steam pressure inside the boiler. So whatever the steam pressure inside the boiler, it is acting on the non-return valve from the top. So it is a downward direction pressure. When the upward pressure is more than the downward pressure, valve lifts up. So if the pressure of water is more than the pressure inside the boiler, then the non-return valve will lift up and allows the flow of high pressure feed water from outside of the boiler to the inside of the boiler. So now if the pressure of feed water is high, non-return valve will move up, lifts up, and the water will enter into the boiler. Now when upward pressure reduces due to power failure or maybe fault in pump or any other reason, downward pressure is more than the upward pressure. So it will happen that due to the power failure or fault, the pressure of feed water will reduce, and in that case downward pressure is high and upward pressure is low. So valve takes its place and don't allow the flow of water from inside of the boiler to the outside of the boiler. above the wall, a stop is located. So this one is a stop. Stop is connected to hand wheel through a spindle. So this is a stop. This is a spindle and it is connected to a hand wheel here. If more quantity of feed water is to be filled inside the boiler, hand wheel is operated and due to that, stop will move up and valve will be lifted more. So stop will decide the, you can say, the operating range of non-return valve. If hand wheel is operated and the stop is moved up, then what will happen? Non-return valve will lifted more. And in that case, more quantity of water will enter into the boiler. Hand wheel is closed if less quantity of water is to be filled into the boiler. So hand wheel can be stopped if less amount of water is to be filled up. Now we are going to study fusible plug. So this one is a sketch for the fusible plug. Now, as the name indicates, fusible, it means it can be fused. Let us see how. Location. It is fitted inside the boiler. So it is the inside part, slightly below the normal water level. It is placed exactly over the furnace of a boiler. So first one is it is inside the boiler drum, and second one is exactly over the furnace of the boiler. The function of the fusible plug is it provides the safety against the overheating in the boiler working. It contains a plug made of fusible metal located in hollow gun metal body. So this one you can see here in the figure. So this dark black color, that is nothing but the fusible metal. Fusible metal means the metal which can be fused easily, which melts easily. And that metal is filled inside the hollow gun metal body. So this one is a hollow gun metal body in which the small amount of the fusible metal is filled. Fusible metal has low melting point and thus it melts when it comes into contact with the steam. During normal operation of boiler, fusible plug is covered under water. When water level in the boiler falls below specific or specified level, the fusible plug is exposed to steam. And thus, plug is overheated and fusible metal melts. So the fusible plug comes into working when the water level inside the boiler falls below specific level. And then after, the fusible metal or the fusible plug is exposed to steam. And due to that, the plug is overheated and the fusible metal melts. Now, as the fusible plug is located exactly over the furnace, the steam from the boiler rushes into the furnace and stops the combustion. And thus, it provides the safety against the overheating of boiler due to low water level. So, we have one device, that is the, you can say, water level indicator. So, if we have seen it properly, if we have watched it properly, and if we have filled the water, then there is no function or there will be no working in the fusible plug. But if the water level continuously reduces and nobody is there to supply the water, and it can be the possible that if the water level has reduced and there is no power, there is a power failure or there is a failure in the pump, and due to that also the water level may reduce and it can overheat the boiler and ultimately it can blast the boiler. And to prevent it, the fusible plug is located below the specific level, water level limit in the boiler. And due to that, when the plug comes into contact with the steam, the fusible metal melts and it provides the safety. Next mounting that we are going to study is the blow off cock. So this one is the figure for the blow off cock. Location. It is located on the bottom most part of the boiler. So it is the lowest part of the boiler where the blow off cock is located. The function of the blow off cock is used to blow off. Blow off means discharge, to remove, to take out. What should be take out? The mud, scale or sediments collected at the bottom of the boiler. So whatever the, you can say, this mud or scale that are collected at the bottom of the boiler, they are to be removed using the blow off cock. Thus it provides the safety against impurities present in the feed water, and it increases the heat transfer rate from smoke to the water. So here it provides the safety and also it controls the transfer of heat. It is also used to drain the water from the boiler in case of cleaning, inspection and repairing of the boiler. It means to empty the boiler. Working. It contains a plug. So you can see this is a plug, which can be opened or closed by using wheel provided at the top. So this plug can be opened or closed by using the wheel provided at the top. At a regular interval, as suggested by the boiler manufacturer, wheel is rotated to open the plug. As there is high pressure inside the boiler, water along with the mud, scale, whatever the sediments are there, comes out at a high pressure. So as this plug opens, whatever the muds or scales are there, along with the water, it comes out with the high pressure. The plug is kept open until clean water comes out from the boiler, and then plug is closed by rotating the wheel. Kindly ask your queries in the comment box of this video. Kindly like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.